We shall now learn how to write a custom action filter for authentication. First of all, you should understand the problem. Consider this situation that I have one action. This is one action and this is another action. Action method and this is action method. Now I want this particular action to be called only by authenticated users, and this action can be called by any user. Now one way of checking the authentication in this action method is to write code here to check whether the user is authenticated or not. But if I have 10 such methods, then I will have to copy paste this code everywhere, or maybe at least manually call a function here. The best way to do this is to write your custom action filter. Custom action filter is an attribute that you can apply on an action method, so that the code for that attribute is called before the action method is called or after the action method is called. Various overloads are there in the base class. We can implement the various overrides to decide on the timing at which the particular code will run. So if I want to write a, see this one for example, this is public action result fx. On this I apply a cust auth filter, cust auth attribute. Now this is an action filter. That is implemented by implementing 4 overrides from the parent class. Those 4 overrides are available for deciding the timing at which the code in that will be called. You can call the code in that before this function fx is executed, or after this is executed, or before the result action result is returned, or after the action result is returned. Custom authorization filter will typically run before the action result, before the action method is called, so that in case the user is not authorized, this function is not called at all. This is one thing. Since we are discussing the topic, I want to discuss one more thing here. MVC allows you to write filters that can be called before every action method. So one type of specification is you can specify that a particular filter is called before any action method of your project. Just like we specify CSS properties in an outside CSS file, they'll apply to any, let us say, div element. Then you can specify styles on a particular element coming closer to that element. Similar is the case here also. Either you specify that a particular filter is called before any action method, and you can specify that a particular attribute or action filter is called before a given action by putting it closer to that action. So how to apply the first one and how to apply the second one? The closest analogy I could think was of the CSS one. Like you can put some specification in the CSS file, and then you can put certain specification closer to that element in the style tag. Similar is the case with this. First one, you specify an action method that an action filter that will be called before any action method. And second one is called before a given action method. How these are specified? And what would their specific uses be? First, I will talk about the uses. In this particular case, the first one, you might have a problem of log. You might want to log which actions in your website are called. So it is better to specify at one place so that before any action is called, your log code will be executed. So this is a candidate for placing it at one place so that it is called before any action method. The second is specify that it is called for a particular action or particular types of actions. This is the case of authentication. You might want only a few actions to be freely callable by anybody. So on those you do not put anything. If you want to put a restriction on a particular category of action methods, you can put closer. Now, how do we specify the first category and how do we specify the second one? Coming to the first one. If you come to your Solution Explorer, you will find your app start file and there is a filter config. Inside filter config, you can write filters.addNewHandleError attribute. Write your own custom class. Override the necessary functions and write here filters.add and create an object of your new class. So depending on what you have overridden in the new class, that code will run at that particular timing for each of the action methods. So filter config is the class where you can specify action methods, action filters that will be called for all methods. And if you want to specify them for a particular one, then the best is to put attributes closer to the action method, like we have put HTTP post. So you can always put attributes closer to the function that you want to be restricted in use. So I summarize. Global action filters can be placed inside the register global filters function. They will apply to all the action methods. And local ones, they can be applied just by typing a square bracket and writing your action method filter here. Now in today's case, we'll demonstrate how we can write a custom authorization filter so that instead of repeating this code everywhere, we just specify a filter here and automatically the authorization runs correctly. Let us do so. For this, we'll add a class . I generally suggest putting it inside a folder. I'll create a folder called utility, right click, add class. So I'm calling C cust auth attribute. Your all custom attributes should be suffixed with attribute. This has been a .NET convention ever since these attributes were introduced. So you put suffix attribute on your class name. This also helps us identify what sort of class this could be. Click add. And this should come from authorize attribute parent class. Right click, resolve MVC. It's MVC. This one you should use. Now we have to override the method that will be called before an action method is called. If you go through the list of all overrides available in authorize attribute, go to definition, then there is on authorization, on cache authorization, handle. So this is a specialized class of a filter attribute. The functions of filter attribute are all available on before action or on after action. You can check up the documentation. But since we are inheriting from a very specialized class authorize attribute, we'll go for overriding the on authorization. So here we are going to override on authorization, and we can check our code here. If filter context dot HTTP context dot user dot identity dot is authenticated, we'll put here if it is not authenticated, then you can write forms authentication resolve this also system.web.security. This is the line that has been added here. Dot redirect to login page. So this is the code that we want to run in case the user is not authenticated. Now how to use this? We'll remove this code from here, because now we don't need to repeat that code everywhere. We'll have to simply write our cust auth attribute on the home controller. So we can write cust auth. Don't need to write attribute at the end of it, because it is automatically taken. Resolve using utility. It is in the utility. So now if we run this, our authorization is implemented. So you can verify. We cannot try to directly reach the welcome page. Clicking it, we are shuttled back to the login page. And we can log in correctly. z@z.com. Password is hoven. Login. And you are taken to the welcome page. So this is how we can write our custom attributes. So in this lecture, we have basically covered how to write global, how to specify global filters. That is, they execute at a proper timing before any action method of your project. Then we'll say specific or local filters. So in this particular example, we implemented a specific or local filter so that it executes before the functions just we specify. And what is the method of? You just have to override, either you override filter attribute directly, in one of the lectures I have demonstrated it, or you, if you are particularly working with authorization, you can just override from the authorize attribute. And the rest is all story. That is the way it works. We'll close it right now. Thanks.